I think maybe 10, 15 years ago, voice acting was more about a voice. But we have 300 hours of gameplay, so you really get to sit in the character. And even in anime, when I'm playing Rin Tosaka, I've played her for 14 years. Like, my whole grown-up animated life, right? So they're asking you to come into the studio and be you in another universe. So not only do you have instincts that match the character, but sometimes they start to write for your instincts. And that's the beautiful thing. It's sort of like surfing. And you are just one with the script writers, and it's just, it's amazing. It's literally a dream life. It's like, I feel like I won the lottery. And so there are times when you're afraid, but in voice acting, it's a director's medium. You really get to trust the director and their big picture, and there are times when they ask you to do things you didn't think you could do, crying in a scene, or, you know, when I remember when I auditioned for When They Cry, Higurashi, she's crazy. But at the very end, she is trying not to be this mass murderer, and she's in love with somebody, and she has an axe in her hand. I mean, this is like, this has never happened to me in real life. So the director is guiding you through these emotions of fighting, and I think one of the reasons anime really kind of touches us is that the extremes that they write about, we all feel in everyday life. We sometimes feel like monsters. We feel like phony heroes. We feel isolated. We feel like we have power that we don't know how to use. We feel like we're drawn differently from another universe, and we've just plopped in here. And I love when a director helps us to connect with the character again so that people all over the world can see themselves in these angsty teenagers or heroes that are trying to figure out their powers. Because aren't we all heroes trying to figure out what to do with what little power we think we have? Yeah. I'm now curious. We have someone in the third row and she's not a hero. Oh. But that's what's beautiful about some of our favorite characters is they don't think they're heroes until the right situation shows up. And we discover that we can't be heroes 90% of the time. But in that one moment, we're exactly what the world needs.